I had a basket in the hall, which had belonged to Bob, the dog who had gotten poisoned. It was a comfortable basket, but I was so excited at having finally met Fred again that I couldn't sleep. Besides, there was a smell of mice everywhere, and I had to move around to try and place it. I was just sniffing at a place in the wall when I heard a scratching noise. At first, I thought it was the mice working at a different place, but when I listened, I found that the sound came from the window. Somebody was doing something with it from outside. If it had been Mother, she would have lifted the roof right there, and so should I, if it hadn't been for what the man had taught me. I didn't think it was possible that this could be the man coming back, for he had gone away and said nothing about ever seeing me again. But I didn't bark. I stopped where I was and listened, and presently the window came open, and I saw somebody climb in. I gave a good sniff, and I knew it was the man. I was so delighted for a moment, I nearly forgot myself and shouted with joy, but I remembered in time how shy he was and stopped myself. But I ran to him and jumped quite quietly, and he told me to lie down. I was disappointed that he didn't seem more pleased to see me. I lied down. It was very dark, but he had brought a lantern with him, and I could see him moving about the room, picking up things and putting them in a bag which he had brought with him. Every now and then he would stop and listen, and then he would start moving around again. He was very quick about it, but very quiet. It was plain that he didn't want Fred or his father to come down and find him. I kept thinking about this peculiarly of his while I watched him. I supposed, being chummy myself, I find it hard to understand that everybody else in the world isn't chummy too. Of course, my experience at the public house taught me that men are just different from each other as dogs. If I chewed Master's shoe, for instance, he used to kick me, but if I chewed Fred's, Fred would tickle me behind the ear. Similarly, some men are shy and some men are mixers. I quite appreciate that, but I couldn't help feeling that the man carried shyness to a point where it became morbid. And he didn't give himself a chance to cure of it. That was the point. Imagine a man hating to meet people so much that he never visited their houses till the middle of the night, where they were in bed asleep. It was silly. Shyness had always been something so outside my nature that I suppose I never really been able to look at it sympathetically. I have always held the view that you can't get over it until you've made an effort. The trouble with the man was that he wouldn't make an effort. He went out of his way to avoid meeting people. I was fond of the man. He was the sort of person you never get to know very well, but we'd been together for quite a while, and I wouldn't have been a dog if I hadn't got attached to him. As I sat and watched him creep around the room, it suddenly came to me that there was a chance to doing him real good turn in spite of himself. Fred was upstairs, and Fred, as I knew by experience, was the easiest man to get along with in the world. Nobody could be shy with Fred. I felt if only I could bring him and the man together, they would get along splendidly, and it would teach the man not to be silly and avoid people. It would help him give the confidence which he needed. I seen him with Bill, and I knew he could be perfectly natural and easy when he liked. It was true that the man might object at first, but after a while he would see that I acted simply for his good, and would be grateful. The difficulty was how to get Fred down without scaring the man. I knew that if I shouted, he wouldn't wait, but he would get out the window and away before Fred could get there. What I had to do was go to Fred's room, explain the whole situation quietly to him, and ask him to come downstairs and meet himself pleasant. The man was far too busy to pay any attention to me. He was kneeling in the corner with his back to me, putting something in his bag. I seized the opportunity and steal softly from the room.